वेलकम टू अ वेरी न्यू पॉडकास्ट फॉर रोलिंग फ्रेम्स एंटरटेनमेंट। और आज की जो हमारी डिस्कशन होने वाली है वो बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग होने वाली, क्योंकि आज हमारे साथ हैं कर्नल अवनीश शर्मा सर। कर्नल अवनीश शर्मा सर हैज सर्व्ड 28 इयर्स इन द इंडियन आर्मी एंड ही इज द मेंबर ऑफ द कोर ग्रुप ऑफ द मिलिट्री लिटरेचर फेस्टिवल चंडीगढ़ इन द टीम लीडर फॉर द क्लैरियन कॉल थिएटर एंड ही हैज बीन राइटिंग as a guest columnist with the Hindustan Times and with the Tribune. And he has always focused in his writings on bridging the gap between the citizens and how they perceive the life of people in the Indian Army. Sir, welcome to our show.
Thank you, Jasvi.
Could you highlight a bit on what bridging the gap is and through your writings?
Okay, yeah. So we'll take the bridging the gap first. I went from the civilian society when I joined the Indian Army. My parents, none from my immediate family was from the armed forces. And I had a good exposure to the civilian way of life. I studied here and did my college and then joined the Indian Military Academy to get commissioned into the Indian Army. And I spent the majority of my life, say 28 years, in the Indian Army. When I took premature retirement 2007 after 28 years of my service. And you see, I've seen both sides of the coin. तो मेरे को ये लगा, पहले भी ये लगता था और जब मैं वापस आया हूँ तब भी ये लगा कि हालांकि things have improved overall, the literacy percentage has increased. People are more aware कि क्या हो रहा है देश में, मीडिया बड़ा एक्टिव है और आजकल ट्रांसपेरेंसी काफ़ी हो गई है सब प्रोफेशंस के बारे में, लेकिन what I realized was that there is still a lot of ignorance about the armed forces in the minds of a normal citizen and they still perceive the armed forces to be that stern kind of soldier with a gun in his hand and, you know, non-approachable, mechanical life. He's on the borders and he's meant to sacrifice his life and he's living in tough conditions and, you know, things are very bad and his family is all neglected and all his parents, his background and all that, he's away from these, it's a 24/7 job. And then, you know, these kind of perceptions which are generally prevalent in everybody's mind. And they are quite content with the fact that the nation's borders and nation's external security is in the hands of Indian Armed Forces. They are doing their job, so that's about it. We just need to know that. But now, with the media getting active and a lot of news coming into the with the general public with regard to the armed forces, I thought it would be better to take this initiative to educate the civilians, especially the youngsters, the civilian, the general readers of, you know, to remove the grey areas of the Indian Armed Forces through wit and humour, through lighter side, so that they can also connect that we are part of the society, we are not away from the society. Whatever happens here, whatever breaking news is here, has an anecdote from the armed forces.
Right.
And this is what my columns are generally, most of my columns are connecting news which happens in everyday life here in the civilian society, and I draw a parallel with an anecdote from my days in the Indian Army and try and give it to the, and it has been quite popular, let me be very frank, and you know, I've been getting very good reviews and comments, surprisingly more from the civilian society rather than my army brethren, because of course they understand what is there and thing. So it is giving me a lot of fulfillment to embark on this kind of, it's not a mission I can say, it is just the way that I write, and I'm really enjoying it. And More importantly is that whatever I write is being accepted by these national dailies, and they are very kind. It's very kind of them to publish it. And that's how this has become my hobby now.
Sir, so how did it occur to you to pick up the pen?
No, I was writing a bit when I was in the army for my service magazines, for professional magazines, and the journals that we have and things like that. I have always been very keen to write and all that. So I said, let me try my hands at these columns. And this is when I came back home in 2007, and I was writing for some magazines. They don't need any acceptance and all. I was writing for the Chandigarh Golf Club magazine. I'm a member of Chandigarh Golf Club, so I used to write. So, and then when I sent my first 3-4 columns, they got rejected. But then finally in 2010, my first column was published in Hindustan Times, and then thereafter it's been very regular. Now you'd be glad to know that I've crossed the 200 mark.
Wow.
last month, and I'm I hope to go strong on that.
So you know, there's abhi to bahut innings padi hai sir.
God willing, it should be it should carry on like
so. Aapne jab likhna shuru kiya, so was it accidental or you know it aap mein tha hamesha se?
No, of course I was very keen on writing. I was I knew that I could write well and things, so it was not accidental per se. But yes, isko configure karna, or when I started writing, I knew that you know it comes to my mind, the flow was good, and I could connect things, and I could infuse that kind of little bit of humor and that attraction for a reader to hook on to it. तो अपने को तो मालूम नहीं पड़ता. मैं आपको बताता हूँ, शुरू में जो मैं एक बारी रेस्टोरेंट में गए, हम बच्चे भी साथ में थे और तो we were just chatting, and there was somebody, suddenly a young girl comes to me, she was there, I didn't notice, then my children told me that she wants to speak with me. So I said, yes, beta. She says, are you Colonel Avneesh Sharma? I said, yes. He says, I know, I'm so fortunate to meet you. I read your piece in Hindustan Times. I almost wept. You know, that was one piece I had written. There was a cousin of mine who was very close to me. He, very handsome guy, very nice fellow. I mean, he got addicted to drugs and alcohol, and got involved in self-abuse, and he died at the age of 50. And so I wrote a piece, Life Less Lived, and she must have read it, and she said, this was one piece I started, it brought tears to my eyes. And then she mentioned another piece, she says, that brought a smile and a this thing to me. So I'm very fortunate. I was taken aback. I was really very happy, you know, this young girl, 22-23 saal ki hogi, must be fond of reading and this thing. So that's what I realized, that yes, I have readers.
So now that you have all the love, support and admiration coming from such a younger age group, and I believe all sorts of age groups. Now, how has your support been to you from the family? How's the family?
Tremendous, tremendous. You know, my latest piece, they've been telling me, so everybody, you know what, at times, most of my writings, I try and rope in my wife when I have to pull a humor, because of course I can't do it on anybody else. So she takes it and she likes it also. She says, of course, at least you're making me a scapegoat and you are trying to progress a story. And similarly, I do it for my daughter-in-law, my daughter, my son-in-law and all that. So they are very happy to see their name in the imprint.
Right.
The latest one, I have written a humor in Innocence that's got published last week. I've given a para on my grandson.
Aye.
And you see, it's just I was trying to project humor in Innocence. So what better innocence than a 3-year-old fellow coming out with an anecdote. And then of course our soldiers in the Indian Army, they are innocent people, they are very simple, they are from the rural background, and they come up with things which at times are really humorous, and that is so that is the thing. Right. I'm enjoying it, and I'm enjoying it. That's a big support to me.
राइट सर. सो वो होता है ना कि कभी कभार घर में ही कोई ह्यूमर रोक भी दिया जाता है. सो आपकी आपका जो एक तरीके से क्रिटिकल रिएक्शन है, डज दैट कम फ्रॉम द हाउस एज वेल?
यस. यू सी व्हेन माय माय बिगेस्ट क्रिटिक इज माय वाइफ एंड फॉलोड बाय माय सन and followed by my daughter. My both my daughter-in-law and my son-in-law are, you know, so diplomatic, because that is the kind of relation that you have. So they will not, so they will, I get to know when they, I said, here is my piece, and my wife and me, we sit outside, we call it an intellectual hour in the morning, when we go through the newspapers and have a cup of tea and appreciate the greenery around us, and we discuss and normally end up fighting on a subject or an issue, whether it is political or a social one. So when she reads the article, so I am waiting for her comments, and she is very frank. She says, "Aaj maza nahi aaya," and sometimes it's very good, it's wonderful. So I know what is lacking, and I try and improve it.
I just want to know out of curiosity, you know, because I have had the same share of critics, you know, coming from the home only. So when you hear it, you know, ki aaj maza nahi aaya. So what do you do next about it? Is that what you would like to know?
Because my first reaction is, yaar, mera piece print hua hai. It is found. It is. It's got printed. It's this thing. It has to be good. Otherwise, these guys will not print it. This is mujhe nahi pasand aaya. So then we have a discussion on that. Okay, it could have been this. You know, sometimes, at times she says, you look, I am not very clear about this subject, what you are discussing. Then I said, okay, fine. Then I take it, because it is probably that you are not aware of what I am talking of. So I agree with him. But then I have my friends, and you know, I have 2-3 friends. They always come back to me and they give me a wonderful feedback. And then my friends, my fellow golfers at the golf club, and of course I get emails from somebody, from people who are regulars in giving me feedback. So I get reasonable amount, and I, the biggest high for me is when I write a piece, I send it, and I get a reply from the editor that yes, it will find print, and then the biggest happiness is when it is printed.
Sir, so I just now out of the topic now moving to our topic, say ki how and why did you, you know, join the Indian Army?
From my immediate family, nobody was in the Indian Armed Forces, and I was somehow enamored with the Armed Forces. I think it is way back, and I was born in 59, and during 65 operations, my father was posted in Ludhiana. He's an agriculture scientist. So he was posted at the Agriculture University in Ludhiana, and we had a siren house next to our house. And then when the forces were mobilized next to the GT road, when the tanks were moving on the big tank trailers, and everybody was standing on the sides and waving them and giving them best of luck, you know, I somehow got it in my mind that I must join the service. But then there was a lot of pressure. I was the only son, and my parents were not very keen. Somehow that time the thinking was that, you know, you should do more here. My father wanted me to be a lawyer. My mother wanted me to be a doctor. Doctor, I was not competent, because I knew I was not too much into studies and all that. Though I took it up, but then I did miserably in my first year. En route to becoming a doctor, so I changed my thing, and my father wanted me to be a lawyer. But then it had that nagging feeling mere dimag mein tha ki maine fauj mein jana hai. To ek mera dost tha jo army officer ka son tha, wo ek din mere ko bol raha tha ki wo Indian Military Academy ke jo UPSC CDS exam hai uske form liye hai, maine lene ja raha hu main. To maine kaha yaar ek mere liye bhi lete aana. So, you won't believe it. My father, my parents didn't know that I asked for these forms. So, humne form diye, humne submit karaya. Pocket money mein se maine uski jo entrance fee hoti hai form ki, wo jama karai, aur result aa gaya. To main to pass ho gaya, but unfortunately, jo mera dost tha, he could not clear. And this is how then I told my parents, look, I've cleared this written exam. I would like to go for the interview. So they said, you never told us that you are getting involved in all this. I said, I wanted to, and this is a good thing. Why not? And it's the first time I'm feeling very happy about it. Then, of course, they were educated parents. They said, okay, go ahead. So I passed my interview and I got selected and I went to the Indian Military Academy.
And so how was your, you know, experience during the training and the early days?
It was tough because हम यहाँ से गए थे, वेगा बॉन्ड थे, कॉलेज में जाते थे, अपने टाइम से जाते थे और फर्स्ट डे फर्स्ट शो देखना है और वही जो काम करते हैं सब जब नए नए कॉलेज में जाते हैं, न्यू फाउंड इंडिपेंडेंस होती है. सो तीन साल ऐसी होके और डिसिप्लिन, हालांकि मेरे पेरेंट्स, माय मदर वाज अ वर्किंग लेडी एंड वी हैड रीजनेबल अमाउंट ऑफ डिसिप्लिन एट होम, बट नथिंग टू कंपेयर द विद द डिसिप्लिन एंड द रिगरस ट्रेनिंग दैट वन गेट्स टू गो थ्रू इन द मिलिट्री अकेडमी बिफोर बिकमिंग एन ऑफिसर. तो बहुत ही टफ था, फिजिकली बड़ा टफ था, मेंटली बड़ा टफ था. सारे फैसेट्स हैं, जैसे हम वहाँ पहुँचे उसके बाद जो हमारा जो रूटीन बना, जिस तरह से हमारी फिजिकल ट्रेनिंग होती है और उसके बाद क्लासरूम्स होती हैं, उसके बाद ऑब्स्टिकल ट्रेनिंग होती है और यू नो वेरियस अदर एक्सरसाइजेज एंड ट्रेनिंग दैट यू अंडरगो. तो मेरे को इन एडिशन टू अ कल्चरल शॉक, इट बिकेम अ फिजिकल एंड अ मेंटल शॉक. तो मैं कुछ दिन के बाद, बिकॉज आई वॉज ऑब्वियसली टेकिंग इट सीरियसली, देर इज़ नो चॉइस, यू हैव टू टेक एवरीथिंग सीरियसली, अदरवाइज देन यू आर इन फॉर ट्रबल. तो आई स्टार्टेड स्लीप वॉकिंग एट नाइट एंड वन डे द फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन बडी फाउंड मी इन अ हॉर्स स्टेबल, यू नो आई हैड स्लिप्ड इन टू द एक्सक्रीटा ऑफ अ हॉर्स एंड वॉज स्लीपिंग देयर. And he got me back and then he, without telling anybody else, because it could have led to more serious repercussions that this guy is sleepwalking, so going to a doctor and all that would have become mandatory. So then, I think in due course of time, I stabilized. I suppose most of the people, when they get into this kind of thing, but it was an experience which I very proudly share that things got back into. And so, and it was a very tough going.
So were there some interesting moments? Everybody has good days in college, good early days. Kuch aise experiences jo shayad hum log samajh paaye.
Dekhiye, jab main training mein jab maine join karna tha Indian Military Academy, to hamare parents ne hame see off kiya Ambala railway station pe. और हम एक स्टील ट्रंक लेके, वो हमको बताया गया था कि ये ऐसे ऐसे आपने लेके आना है. तो एक बेडिंग था, एक स्टील ट्रंक था और हम थे, हम सोच रहे थे हम जा रहे हैं, अभी अफसर बन गए हैं तो उस समय हम कैडेट की तरह जा रहे थे. तो हम वहाँ देहरादून रेलवे स्टेशन में उतरे और वहाँ पे आके हम देख रहे हैं दाहिने बाएं कि कहाँ पर है हमारा रिसेप्शन, कहाँ पर है हमारी जीप. So then, and there was one officer, one captain from the Indian Military Academy who was there to welcome us with the reception desks were laid down and all that. So we asked him, ki, Captain, kahan par hai bhai? He says, gentlemen, wake up. You are no more in the civil. You are not a student. You are a cadet. Pick up your bedding in one hand and lift up your bloody trunk and get into that truck. And don't ask questions. Get out of the mold of a civilian. That's when we realized that, you know, there is something wrong. We thought we are going to go and become officers and this is going to be very tough. So the moment we thought we'll go straight into our room, the vehicle, the truck will go into. So we were in the truck, about 20 of us behind, sitting on our trunk with the bedding on our side, and the truck trudged us into the Indian military. The first stop was in the hairdresser saloon, and he said, "You all of you get down and take a haircut." So we said, "We have already taken a haircut. Hey, get down and get into the queue." And that is the time when I realized what is called an army cut, a crew cut, and then it followed, and then it became, of course, became a habit.
Yeah. I know the wo jo pehla pal hota hai na wo sabse yaadgar ban jata hai.
Yes.
Sir, you know, after having served the Indian Army for 28 years now, how would you say the overall life has been serving for the Indian Army, serving for the nation India?
Dekho, Ojasvi, sab kaam karte hain, chahe doctor le lijiye, aap engineer le lijiye, police, Indian administrative service, businessmen, entrepreneurs, people like you who are creative, they are all contributing to nation building. The only difference in the other profession and the profession in the military is one, I realize now that in no profession you can tell the people under your command to embrace death. You can command men into death, into war, where you know you may not come back. But then there is another thing. It is, they will only follow a leader who is willing to lead them. You see, in no profession. कौन बोल रहे हो कौन बोल रहे भैया तुम शहीद हो जाओ नहीं देयर आर अदर ऑप्शन हियर दिस ऑप्शन इज एम्ब्रेस्ड अनक्वेश्चनिंगली दिस इज द डिफरेंस एंड सो दैट रिपोजेस अ लॉट ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑन अ लीडर टू इंश्योर दैट ही इज फर्स्टली ही इज कॉम्पिटेंट सेकेंड ही ट्रेन्स हिज मैन प्रॉपरली ही अंडरस्टैंड्स द सिचुएशन एंड दैट इज द ओनली way or the only thing that can empower him or authorize him to tell his men to go into war. So that is a huge feeling that doesn't come anywhere else. ये बाकी तो छोटी चीजें हैं हमारे एडवेंचर बड़ा अच्छा है स्पोर्ट्स फैसिलिटीज बड़ी अच्छी होती हैं हम दुनिया भर की जगह देखते हैं नॉर्थ ईस्ट भी देखते हैं राजस्थान भी देखते हैं जे एंड के भी देखते हैं वो सब बातें हैं
जी
लेकिन ये जो बहुत बड़ी चीज है ये दिस इज दैट दिस सेपरेट्स द प्रोफेशन ऑफ आर्म्स फ्रॉम अदर प्रोफेशंस
राइट जी सर कभी एहसास हुआ डर का
हाँ वो तो जो डरता नहीं है लेकिन हाँ जब एक बहुत बड़ी जो क्वालिटी है मिलिट्री में वो है टीम वर्क सो व्हेन यू आर अलोन यू आर obviously scared but when you are together and you know that all of you are one and one guy is going to protect the other fear doesn't come near you
right
fear doesn't come I'll tell you one incident it happened with a colleague of mine he was posted in J&K as a company commander as a major aur unko task mila aur khabar aayi ki is gaon mein ugrawadi hain तो आप तो पूरी कंपनी थी वो मोबिलाइज हो गई उन्होंने वो जैसे ड्रिल होती है ट्रेनिंग है कि घेरा डाल लिया रात को घेरा डाल लिया पूरा नाके छाके लगा के पूरा कर दिया और सवेरे सर्च शुरू होनी थी ताकि कोई अंदर ना आ सके कोई बाहर ना जा सके और फिर ये जब डे लाइट होती है तो ये सवेरे उस समय एक सिस्टम चलता था बडी सिस्टम अभी भी चलता है कि कोई भी आदमी कोई भी फौजी अकेला नहीं घूमेगा एक बात नहीं साथ में होएगा उसके ये ड्रिल है इट इज बेसिकली टू गिव देम अ फीलिंग ऑफ सिक्योरिटी और कुछ हो जाता है तो दूसरा आदमी रिएक्ट कर सकता है एक बंदा इधर जा सके दूसरा बंदा बैठा हुआ है तो काम कर सकता तो हमारा भी वो जो हमारे जो कलीग थे उनका भी बडी था उनका ऑपरेटर तो सवेरे का टाइम हो गया तो वो अपने आप को रिलीव करने के लिए जो लोटा परेड जिसको बोलते हैं सवेरे जब जाते हैं तो वो कहते हैं मैं अकेला जाऊंगा तो वो कहता नहीं साहब मैं साथ में जो कहता नहीं तुम फिक्र मत करो तुम यहीं करो तो वो मेजर साहब गए और झाड़ी के पीछे उन्होंने अपनी पतलून निकाली और अपनी कार्रवाई करने शुरू हुए तो एकदम उठ के खड़े हो गए सामने उग्रवादी निकला एक उससे और उसके हाथ में AK-47 थी और उसने अपनी AK-47 उन मेजर साहब के ऊपर सिधाई एंड सडनली ही सॉ दैट टेररिस्ट ओजिंग ब्लड फ्रॉम हिज चेस्ट और पीछे मुड़ के देखा तो उनके बडी ने जिसको उसने बोला था कि मत आओ उसने उनके हुक्म की उल्लंघना की बट डिसिप्लिन था कि उसने कहा ये जो मर्जी बोलते जाए मैं तो इनके साथ ही रहूंगा उसने उसको मार दिया अगर वो यहां पे वहां पे नहीं होता तो वो गए थे
जी
यू सी दैट इज द काइंड ऑफ बोन होमी एंड कमराडरी विच एग्जिस्ट इन द इंडियन आर्मी एंड इट मूव्स ऑन डिसिप्लिन इट मूव्स ऑन ट्रेनिंग सो व्हेन यू हैव दीज टू थ्री थिंग्स फियर डजंट रियली कम इन
जी सर ऐसे तो बहुत बहुत यादगार पल होंगे, लॉट ऑफ अनफॉरगेटेबल एंड रादर आई वुड से अनफॉरगिवेबल मोमेंट्स आल्सो समटाइम्स इफ यू पुट इट इन द अदर लाइट. सो वो कितने को रहे हैं या कोई खास ऐसा कोई अनफॉरगेटेबल मोमेंट आपके करियर में?
देखिए ओजस्वी, एवरी डे इज अ न्यू डे. देयर देयर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स व्हिच हैपन. माय टेन्योर्स इन राजस्थान, एक्सरसाइजेस, वॉर एक्सरसाइजेस, पराक्रम. जब हम मोबिलाइज हुए थे, जब इंडियन पार्लियामेंट के ऊपर अटैक हुआ था 2002 में, उस समय पूरी इंडियन आर्मी मोबिलाइज हो गई थी और लड़ाई के लिए बिल्कुल तैयार बैठे. उस समय मैं अपनी यूनिट को कमांड कर रहा था, सीओ था अपनी यूनिट का. तो उस पल के जो कुछ काम मेरे को यादें हैं वो बहुत याद आती हैं. जब और कुछ उ, 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 कुछ यादें हैं जो जब मैं यंग ऑफिसर था, किस तरह से मैंने अपने ट्रुप को लीड किया, किस तरह रात के वक्त हम 70-70 किलोमीटर बिना कोई नेविगेशन का तरीका नहीं होता था, उस समय जीपीएस नहीं आए थे और कंपास होता था और वो भी कभी चलते थे कभी नहीं चलते थे, तो उसके मुताबिक किस तरह से हमने अपनी ट्रेनिंग की है. बहुत है, तो बहुत ज़्यादा है. लेकिन इसके आउट ऑफ द आर्मी मैं आपको एक बड़ी ज़बरदस्त किस्सा सुनाता हूँ, विच आई एट्रीब्यूट टू माई ट्रेनिंग इन दी आर्मी एंड दी जज्बा दैट आई इम्बाइब्ड थ्रू माई ट्रेनिंग, थ्रू माई कमराडरी, थ्रू दी एक्ट्स ऑफ वैलर एंड करेज बाई माई कोलीग्स. उनको देखिए, मैं हम जा रहे थे, ये फौज का किस्सा नहीं है, बाहर का है. हम हमारे फादर के पास फीएट कार हुआ करती थी और हम हमारी सिस्टर, हमारे मदर और हमारी वाइफ और उस समय मेरा माई सन वॉज देयर स्मॉल चाइल्ड और हम जा रहे थे शिमला. और इधर रास्ते में परवानू में हम कुछ गाड़ी का सामान लेने के लिए खड़े हुए एंड माय फादर एंड मी वी वेंट टू द शॉप. द कार वाज बिहाइंड व्हेन सडनली माय फादर लुक बैक, दैट कार हैड स्टार्टेड स्लाइडिंग एंड मूविंग एंड जस्ट अबाउट 15 फीट अवे फ्रॉम दैट देयर वाज अ डीप गॉर्ज, डीप कट. सो ही वॉज शेल शॉक्ड, यू नो, ओल्ड मैन, ही वॉज शॉक्ड. एंड आई देन रैन विदाउट थिंकिंग, यू नो, वन कुड थिंक एंड कीप ऑन थिंकिंग कि अब क्या करें. एंड बाय द टाइम द कार वुड गेट इन टू द गॉर्ज एंड देन ऑफकोर्स माई मदर वॉज सिटिंग देयर, माई वाइफ वॉज सिटिंग देयर, माई सिस्टर वॉज सिटिंग देयर, माई सन वॉज इन दैट कार एंड दे वर शाउटिंग. They probably didn't realize. They were chatting and things like that. And suddenly when it's, then the car picked up speed, they didn't know what to do. So I, meantime, I said, there was no time for taking a decision. So I just put my hands and with lot of faith in my power, which was there or not there, I didn't realize that time. I came in front of the car and stood there trying to stall it coming down. It is the most foolhardy thing. Because it is when the car picks up speed and is moving downhill, one person stalling it is very difficult. It would definitely mean me going first into the cut and then the car on top of me and in the car the other members of my family and things like that. Aur Jaswi, aapko yakeen nahi hoega ki I don't know kya hua. The car stopped during the process of picking up speed. And I don't attribute this to my strength, physical strength, because it is unimaginable. I attribute it to two things. It is my faith in my decision and my ability to face a situation head on. And of course, the power of the Almighty. And I attribute this to my training in the military. And the faith that it gives to a person to handle situations with head on.
That I would say that, you know, your training in the military has trained you to be, you know, physically, mentally and emotionally, you know, considering all spheres, very, very, very strong. To, you know, even, you know, respond, I wouldn't say react, but respond in times or take action in times where there's hardly any thinking time.
Absolutely. It is unimaginable. It just gets ingrained in you. Kyunki thinking consumes time. Thinking of a situation which is obvious portrays lesser training. The spur of the moment, then it goes.
So talking about physical, mental and emotional strength, you know, the youth of today, the Indian youth of today, who is relatively at a very younger age now, I mean, you're just moving into your teens and out of your teens and then thinking about, you know, choosing to be a part of the Indian Army as a career. So how does one prepare oneself mentally, emotionally, to, you know, be a part of the Indian Army? So what is the training, mental training one has to go through to prepare to decide whether one wants to be a part of the Indian Army?
Look, today's youth is very, very aware. I find their level of intelligence, their level of focus and awareness is much more than what was there with youngsters during our time. What I think they'll make wonderful leaders, but they need to take care of a couple of things. The first thing is the discipline. They have to inculcate a sense of discipline, whether it is with respect to their routine, their hobbies, their conduct in public life, their conduct with their elders, their conduct with their colleagues, their conditioning to undertake things in an appropriate manner. The other thing is their personal habits. The drug menace and indulgence in things which are unbecoming of a youngster should be avoided, should be shunned, and they need to realize that that will spell doom for them. And that is where I would like the parents and the teachers to come into play. The indulgence, like you said, that your next venture is a movie, this thing on cyber. The threats from cyber anomalies, which kids are indulging in and parents need to be made aware of, is another thing which needs to be kept in mind. They need to be physically fit. You see, my experience is at the age of 60 now, that unless you are physically fit, you cannot be mentally strong. Because if you are fatigued, where is the power to think?
Correct.
अगर तुम थक चुके हो तुम क्या सोचोगे? तुम सीधा सोच नहीं सकते हो. तुम दम नहीं है तुम्हारे में. तुमने अपनी बॉडी को कंडीशन नहीं किया. या तो नशे में खो दिया या सुस्ती में खो दिया या अपने रूटीन में खो दिया
या मोबाइल में, इंटरनेट में.
मोबाइल, इंटरनेट, सोशल मीडिया, नो वैल्यू. उसका क्या, कोई वैल्यू नहीं है. एजुकेशनल वैल्यू है वो तुम किताबों में है या एजुकेशनल चीजों को परसू करने में है. ये फालतू के चीजें, दे आर पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ, यू कांट अवॉइड इट बिकॉज दैट दे एग्जिस्ट एज ऑफ टुडे, बट देयर हैज टू बी सम लिमिट टू देम. देयर हैज टू बी सम लिमिट ऑफ डिसेंसी ऑफ सोशल लाइफ.
सो आई एम, मैं ये मानूं कि डिसिप्लिन इज द की, मतलब
की
एंड बैलेंस आल्सो.
योर डिसिप्लिन, योर फिजिकल फिटनेस इज ऑफ पैरामाउंट इंपॉर्टेंस. इफ यू आर डूइंग बोथ ऑफ देम एंड you are sane thinking fellow, nothing can stop you. And let me tell all youngsters who you interact with or who are going to watch this or listen to this, is that armed forces is one of the professions who are looking for youngsters who are physically fit, mentally alert. It has a lot of things to offer to them. It's a life you can't imagine. It's only when you take a jump in this profession, you realize it is the best profession for in today's time. It's a clean profession. You lead a life of discipline. Your families lead a life of discipline. They have everything to look forward to. And the opportunities are endless.
बहुत अच्छा लगा सर आज आपसे बात करके एंड यू नो गेटिंग टू नो ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन लिटिल बिट ऑफ द इनसाइट इनटू हाउ द यूथ कैन एक्चुअली यू नो प्रिपेयर देमसेल्व्स और कंडीशन देयर माइंडसेट्स व्हेन दे डिसाइड टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ द इंडियन आर्मी और आपके जो किस्से थे यू नो योर अनफॉरगेटेबल मोमेंट्स द मोमेंट्स दैट वर रियली हाई पॉइंट्स इन द करियर एंड I must say there must be some low points as well, but you know, when you are mentally strong, emotionally strong, so the low points give us a learning and then, you know, we transform them into something that becomes high point later in the stage. So aaj ka ye jo episode hai, ye bahut hi ek interesting episode, jaisa ki humne show ke starting mein kaha tha, hoga aur hai bhi. So thank you for listening to this very special episode with Colonel Avneesh Sharma. On Rolling Frames Entertainment, sir, any last words to the audience?
No, it's such a pleasure. I'm grateful to you and your ventures. I've seen you grow over a period of time. And I wish you all the best because you are doing a wonderful thing for the society. You're making them aware. You're making them, you're entertaining them through your work. And Godspeed to you.
Thank you so much. So stay tuned and subscribe to Rolling Frames Entertainment and we look forward to more sessions with Colonel Avneesh Sharma and see you soon.